OLED, organic light emitting diode. OLED is the LED in which electroluminescent layer is a thin film of organic compounds. It is also known as organic electroluminescent diode. It has many uses. It is used to create digital displays in television screens, computer monitors, smartphones, etc. Now we need to know the history of OLED. In 1950, André Bernanos and co-workers first observed electroluminescence in organic materials. Then in 1960, Martin Pope and co-workers developed ohmic dark injecting electrode contacts to organic crystals. Then in 1965, Wolfgang Helfrich and W.G. Schneider produced double injection recombination electroluminescence. In 1965, Dow Chemical Researchers patented a method of preparing electroluminescent cells. Roger Partridge made first observation of electroluminescence from polymer films. Now we are saying about practical OLEDs. Ching Van Tang and Steven Van Slyke built the first practical OLED device. It was a two-layer structure and it needed low operating voltage and high efficiency. Then in 1990, J.H. Barovius and co-workers developed green light emitting devices. In 1999, Kodak and Sanyo started research for OLED display. Then in 2002, they presented 15-inch HDTV display based on white OLED. Then the companies Samsung, Panasonic, Sony, etc. started to develop OLED displays. Components of OLED. Components of OLED mainly includes cathode, emissive layer, conducting layer, anode and substrate. Cathode injects electrons when a current flows through the device. Emissive layer transport electron from the cathode and conducting layer transport holes from the anode. Anode add electron holes when a current flows through the device. Substrate supports the OLED. It may be clear plastic, glass, foil, etc. This is the picture showing OLED structure. Now we are looking for the structure of OLED. Mainly used organic semiconductors are AlQ3 and diamine. Both contain 6 benzene rings but with a different molecular arrangement. Here diamine is used as hole transport layer and AlQ3 is used as a electron transport layer. OLED has a number of layers on a transparent substrate like glass. Onto the substrate, a transparent conductive anode like indium tin oxide. Then it has a hole transport layer like diamine. Then an electron transport layer like AlQ3. Then a cathode contact like magnesium alloy with 10% Ag. Now we look for the OLED working. When a voltage is applied, electron flow from cathode to anode. Also, holes withdrawn from anode. They will accumulate at the interface to enhance radiative recombination. Then they combine to form photons and emit it as light. This is the picture of OLED working. Here we can see that electron and holes combine to form light. Now we can see the design criteria. Ultra thin layers for low biasing voltage and low injection barriers, that is barrier height for hole injection and that for the electron injection must be low. proper band gaps for required color. By using ALQ3 we get green color. So we can use organic materials with the proper band gaps for required color. Carrier balance. Balanced charge injection and transfer are required to get high internal efficiency, high stability and pure emission of luminance layer without contaminated emission from charge transporting layers. A common way to balance charge is optimizing the thickness of the charge transporting layer, but it is hard to control. Another way to balance charge is using exciplex. Exciplex is found between hole transporting and electron transporting side chains to localize electron hole pairs. It provides high efficiency and improve color purity. Now we see the features of OLED. OLED display works without backlight because it emits visible light. OLEDs can be made transparent, which is used in smartphones with optical fingerprint scanner. OLEDs can be made flexible, which is used in foldable smartphones. Now we can see two types of OLED, PM OLED and AM OLED. OLED display can be driven with a passive matrix called PM OLED or active matrix AM OLED control scheme. In PM OLED scheme, each row in the display is controlled sequentially one by one, and in AM OLED scheme uses a thin film transistor. Passive matrix OLED. It has strips of cathode, organic layers and strips of anode. Anode strips are arranged perpendicular to the cathode strips. The intersections of the cathode and anode make up the pixels where light is emitted, and brightness of each pixel is proportional to the amount of applied current. It is easy to make but consume more power than other types of OLED. It is best suited for small screen like cell phones, MP3 players, etc. Active matrix OLED. It have full layers of cathode, organic molecules and anode. But anode layer overlays a thin film transistor array that forms a matrix. TFT array itself is the circuitry that determines which pixels get turned on to form an image. AM OLEDs consume less power than PM OLEDs because TFT array require less power than external circuitry. It has faster refresh rates and it is used in computer monitors, electronic signs, etc. Different types of OLED includes transparent OLED, top emitting OLED, foldable OLED and white OLED. Transparent OLEDs. It is used to create displays. It greatly improve contrast. Much easier to view displays in bright sunlight. Also, it is used in augmented reality applications. There are bottom and top emitting OLEDs. Bottom or top distinction refers to the direction that emitter light exits through the device. Bottom emitting OLED, light emitted passes through the bottom electrode. Here we are discussing about top emitting OLEDs. Light emitted exits through the lid that is added following the fabrication of the device. It is better suited for active matrix application. It can be more easily integrated with a non-transparent transistor backplane. It is used in smart cards. Foldable OLED. This is another type of OLED. They have substrates made of very flexible metallic foils or plastics. They are very lightweight and durable. Their use in cell phones can reduce breakage. They are used to make displays and can be attached to fabrics to create smart clothing. White OLED. It emits white light. It is more brighter, more uniform and more energy efficient. Their use will reduce energy costs for lighting. They can replace fluorescent lights. SM OLED or small molecule OLED. This is another type of OLED. It is made by using small molecules. It was first developed by Chin Van Tang and co-workers. Commonly used molecules in it is organometallic chelates, fluorescent and phosphorescent dyes, etc. Production of SM OLED involves thermal evaporation in vacuum, but it is expensive. Another type of OLED is polymer OLED. It is made by polymer molecules. It involves an electroluminescent conductive polymer. It is quite efficient and requires relatively small amount of power. It is used as a thin film for full spectrum color displays. Phosphorescent OLED. It uses the principle of electrophosphorescence to convert electrical energy in OLED into light in a highly efficient manner. Typically, a polymer like N-vinyl carbosol is used as a host material to which organometallic complex is added. It has improved internal quantum efficiency. Stacked OLEDs. It uses a pixel architecture. It stacks the red, green and blue subpixels on top of one another instead of next to one another. It substantially increases color depth and greatly reduces pixel gaps. Inverted OLED. As the name shows, it has an inverted architecture. In conventional OLED, cathode is placed on the substrate. In inverted OLED, anode is placed on the substrate. That is, it uses bottom cathode. Bottom cathode can be connected to the drain end of an N-channel thin film transistor. Flexible OLED. A flexible OLED is based on a flexible substrate, which can be either plastic, metal or flexible glass. The plastic and metal panels will be light, thin and very durable. The first range of devices that use flexible OLED displays are not really flexible. The device maker bends or curves the display, but final user is not able to actually bend the device. Second generation of flexible OLED displays can be bent by the user. It was introduced in 2019 and include Samsung Galaxy Fold and Huawei Mate X. Both are smartphones that open up to become tablet devices with foldable OLEDs. In 2019, LG announced world's first rollable OLED display. Flexible OLED displays are thinner, lighter and more durable than glass-based displays. Manufacturing of OLED. The biggest part of manufacturing OLEDs is applying organic layer to the substrate. This can be done in three ways. First one is vacuum thermal evaporation. In this process, in a vacuum chamber, organic molecules are generally heated and allowed to condense as thin films onto cooled substrate. This process is expensive. Second way is organic vapor phase deposition. In this process, in a low pressure hot walled reactor chamber, a carrier gas transports evaporated organic molecules onto cooled substrate and they condense to thin films. Another way is inkjet printing. Here OLEDs are sprayed onto substrate just like ink sprayed onto paper during printing. Commercial applications of OLED. Nokia introduced OLED mobile phones with AMOLED display. Samsung introduced color cell phones. Also, OLED displays used in watches. Now, foldable OLED display used in smartphones. Samsung applications. In 2008, Samsung announced world's largest and thinnest OLED TV at the time. Also in 2008, They introduced ultra-thin laptop OLED display. In 2013, they introduced unique curved 4K Ultra OLED TV. Also in 2013, they introduced Galaxy Round smartphones. Apple applications. In 2015, Apple used OLED panels in watches. In 2016, they used OLED in laptops. In 2017, they introduced iPhone X with their own optimized OLED display. Also, OLED is used in iPhone XS, iPhone XS Max, etc. This is the picture of a curved OLED display. OLED lighting. OLED creates beautiful and efficient light source, but it has high price for production. In early years, several makers like Philips, Panasonic, etc. had active OLED lighting programs. But slowly they dropped out of the market, mainly because of high price of production and competition with LED lighting was extremely difficult. Several companies still produce OLED lighting panels. This is the picture of an OLED display. The future of OLED display. OLEDs represent the future of display technology. OLEDs can be used to create flexible and transparent displays. It is exciting as it opens up a whole world of possibilities like wearable OLEDs, foldable and rollable OLEDs, transparent OLEDs embedded in windows, etc. Now we can see the advantages of OLED. It uses lower power. It has greater brightness. It has better durability and has lighter weight. It has an excellent emissive quality with a wider viewing angle. It has faster refresh rate and better contrast. Disadvantages of OLED. Water damage. Water can instantly damage organic materials used in OLED. It is expensive to produce OLED, but in future it may be of low cost. Then in problem in direct sunlight due to emissive nature. Also, OLED has limited lifetime. Another disadvantage of OLED is color balance. In OLED, degradation occurs because of accumulation of non-radiative recombination centers. OLED producing blue light degrades more rapidly, so it will change color balance of display. To avoid this, we need advanced control circuits. So this is a disadvantage of OLED. Another disadvantage of OLED is power consumption. OLED consumes 60-80% power used by LCD for displaying majority of images. But OLED uses more than 300% power than LCD to display image with white background. So this will reduce battery life in mobiles. Now we can compare OLED and LCD, that is organic light emitting diode and liquid crystal display. OLED use independent illuminated pixels while LCD screen use background light to display image. OLED screens have a layer made of organic material, but LCD doesn't have it. LCD is a liquid crystal display consisting of a matrix of liquid cells. OLED technology is more expensive than LCDs. OLED can provide better and more natural colors than LCDs. OLED and LED TVs. LED TVs are available in both 1080 pixel HD and 4K Ultra HD, while OLED is 4K only. Picture quality of OLED TV is superior than LED TVs. OLED TV have wide viewing angle than LED TVs. Research in the field of OLED. In 2014, Mitsubishi Chemical Corporation developed OLED panel with 30,000 hour life. research for cameras under OLEDs are going on. In 2018, Samsung started research for fingerprint on display FOD, sound on display SOD, etc. Conclusion: OLEDs made using organic compounds. OLED is very useful for multicolor, large area flat panel display. OLED has advantages and disadvantages. In future, foldable and rollable OLED devices may be available. White OLED is one of the major areas of research.